Graph the quadratic function to determine the domain and range, use interval notation. To graph the functions, we'll use a table of values. First, we have f of x equals x squared minus 2, which we may recognize is the parent function f of x equals x squared shifted down 2 units, but we'll go ahead and complete a table of values. Let's use x values or inputs of 0, 1, negative 1, 2, and negative 2. F of 0 is equal to the square of 0 minus 2 or negative 2. F of 1 is equal to the square of 1 minus 2, which is 1 minus 2 or negative 1. F of negative 1 equals the square of negative 1 minus 2. The square of negative 1 is positive 1. Positive 1 minus 2 is negative 1. F of 2 equals the square of 2 minus 2. The square of 2 is 4. 4 minus 2 is 2. And F of negative 2 equals the square of negative 2 minus 2. The square of negative 2 is positive 4, positive 4 minus 2 is 2. Let's go ahead and plot the points on the coordinate plane, 0 comma negative 2, 1 comma negative 1, negative 1 comma negative 1, 2 comma 2, and negative 2 comma 2. And notice, again, we do have the graph of the basic parabola, f of x equals x squared, shifted down 2 units. And now to determine the domain and range. Recall the domain is a set of all inputs or x values. The range is a set of all outputs or y values. Looking at the function f of x equals x squared minus 2, we should be able to recognize x can be any real number, or analyzing the graph horizontally or from left to right, the graph does continue to move left indefinitely as well as right indefinitely without any holes or breaks, which indicates the domain is all real numbers. If we graph the domain on the x-axis, we would graph the entire number line. Using interval notation, the domain is the open interval from negative infinity to positive infinity. To determine the range, we analyze the graph vertically, or from the bottom to the top. Notice the lowest point is the vertex where y equals negative 2, and from there the graph goes up indefinitely and y approaches positive infinity. If we were to graph the range on the y-axis, we'd have a closed point at y equals negative 2 and an arrow up. The range is y greater than or equal to negative 2, which using interval notation is the interval from negative 2 to infinity. Negative 2 is included in the interval, and therefore we say the interval is closed on negative 2, indicating we use a square bracket to the left of negative 2, and we use a parenthesis to the right of infinity. For the second example, we have g of x equals negative 2x squared plus 4. Let's use the same inputs or x values of 0, 1, negative 1, 2, and negative 2. G of 0 equals negative 2 times the square of 0 plus 4. The square of 0 is 0, negative 2 times 0 is 0, 0 plus 4 is 4. G of 1 equals negative 2 times the square of 1 plus 4. The square of 1 is 1, negative 2 times 1 is negative 2, negative 2 plus 4 is 2. G of negative 1 equals negative 2 times the square of negative 1 plus 4. The square of negative 1 is positive 1, negative 2 times positive 1 is negative 2, negative 2 plus 4 is 2. G of 2 equals negative 2 times the square of 2 plus 4. The square of 2 is 4. Negative 2 times 4 is negative 8. Negative 8 plus 4 is negative 4. And finally, g of negative 2 equals negative 2 times the square of negative 2 plus 4. The square of negative 2 is positive 4. Negative 2 times positive 4 is negative 8. Negative 8 plus 4 is negative 4. And now let's plot the points, 0, 4, 1, 2, negative 1, 2, 2, negative 4, and negative 2, negative 4. Notice now we have a parabola that opens down. Analyzing the graph horizontally or from left to right, notice there are no holes or breaks in the graph, and the graph continues to move left as well as right indefinitely, and therefore the domain is all real numbers. Or looking at the function, notice The input can be any value of x. The input x can be any real number. The domain is the open interval from negative infinity to positive infinity. If we were to graph the domain on the x-axis, we would graph the entire x-axis. To determine the range, we analyze the graph vertically. Notice the highest point on the graph is the vertex where y equals positive 4, and then from there the graph goes down and y approaches negative infinity, which means the range is y less than or equal to positive 4, which if we were to graph, we'd have a closed point on y equals positive 4 and an arrow going down. We need to be careful when giving the range using interval notation. Using interval notation, we don't want to say from 4 to negative infinity. We need to have the interval in the order of negative infinity, comma, 4. We use a rounded parenthesis to the left of negative infinity, and because 4 is in the interval, or because the interval is closed on 4, we use a square bracket to the right of positive 4. I hope you found this helpful.